fact, I wanted to take that that question to Dr. Tholalikar. Sir, this is what I don't understand. One of the concerns, as has been stated in the United Kingdom and the rules as I understand it, is that they're looking out for different variants. Now, Delta has surged across the United Kingdom. It's the same variant. Delta Plus, according to the World Health Organization, is not a variant of immediate concern, right? So therefore, that argument falls apart as well. And we have, to the best of our knowledge, contained Delta Plus. It doesn't represent the threat that many thought it did.
Thank you. Thank you, Vishnu, for having me on the show. I mean, I agree with most of your other panelists. I think there is a bit of a common sense lacking here, or there's a bit of lack of logic here. When the initial amber, green, and the red list criteria were made, they were based on four criteria. One is that the percentage of the population of the country which has been vaccinated. Two, the rate of infection with the variants. The prevalence of any variants there, and finally, sort of countries' access to genomic sequencing and reliable scientific data. So these were the four criteria on which mm-hmm. they were being distributed into red category, amber category, and the green category. Now the situation is such that India has the same variant that's been the dominant variant in the UK. We also know that at the moment, the cases are actually coming down. So you could argue that it is time now to move India from red to the amber list. And I think that is the focus here, is that they're not doing the red to the amber shift. Why that is? Is it because genomic sequencing is not enough? Is it because the percentage of population is not vaccinated? Now, you could argue this is not enough because the students who are coming in are saying they've had both their vaccines. So you can't really hold that against the students who are coming in. So what I would have suggested in this situation, which is really unfortunate and very difficult situation for these students who've worked hard to come in here, is that if you can't move India from the red to the amber list now because of these criteria, then at least make a separate pathway for these international students, because they can give you a proof of their vaccination. Correct. They can show that they've had the two vaccine doses. So you can make a pathway so that at least they can be given a bit of benefit of doubt and a bit of leeway in this system so that they can enter easier, like amber category.
Absolutely. That there needs to be a pathway perhaps established for these students. Thank you all very much for being with us.